Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So, as you probably saw, or probably didn't see, I didn't post yesterday, and that's because I was at my sister's house helping her with some things, and I couldn't find a decent spot to film this video. So I'm going to do what I did a couple days ago, where I do yesterday's video and today's video. Also, I have a stuffed nose, so that's why I sound different. And so the first video, which would have been yesterday's video, was requested by my best friend, and she said to do a holiday makeup tutorial. And it's been a while since I've done a makeup tutorial. I think the last time I did a makeup tutorial was about a year ago. I think last one I did, I think, was either the Mind Stone, I think, was the last one I did. I still have yet to do the Soul Stone, the Power Stone, and the actual Human Infinity Gauntlet. I promise those will be soon. Maybe. I don't know. So, I have my makeup right here. And I'm just going to show you, actually, if I can stand up, that it's going to be based around this holiday dress that I made. It's supposed to have a petticoat under it, so it'd be a little floofier, but this is a little more comfortable for me to sit down in without having to worry about the petticoat. I don't know if you can see, there are cardinals on it, and it's this pretty cream color, and I love it. It is pleated because, yeah. Alright, sitting back down. It is cotton, by the way. It is cotton. Also, something else that's on this is music notes. But it's like a really fine detail that you'd have to look at the fabric up close to see. So, time to do my makeup. This makeup is going to be kind of 1950s inspired because that's the silhouette of this dress. And just like any of my makeup tutorials, except this time I won't be putting my hair back up in a wig cap. I will just be throwing it back up into a ponytail just to keep it out of my face. Also, I did take a shower last night, so that's why my hair is back to its curly mop mess. I'm gonna combine today's video and yesterday's video because I was actually gonna do a more talkative video today anyway because I didn't have any ideas. So we'll do that. So the first thing I'm going to start with is my powder foundation in the 1950s. The cream, foundation wasn't, I don't think it was even invented yet, but powder, they used on pancake makeup, which is what that is. And they used this makeup that they would, it was dry, and then you'd apply it wet and it would give you an overall matte finish, which is the equivalent to powder foundation. So if you've ever heard the term I have to go powder my nose, it means you have a shiny, and a shiny is like, and they mainly happen in your nose, but since my nose is like matte, if it starts to shimmer, it's a shiny, and then you'd go and just fix it. Also, your powder foundation can really change your skin tone. My skin is naturally pale, so yeah. Now that's out of the way. Next thing I'm gonna do is eyebrow pencil. I actually don't darken my eyebrows. I just use the little brush groom thing that are supposed that darken them. And this is another aspect of the 50s. Women would fill in their eyebrows with pencils and make them darker. If you've ever seen a picture of Elizabeth Taylor, you'll understand. See, my eyebrows are darker. You can see them now. I look angry. Next would be the blush. Now, I have two blushes here. I have a more pink one that I actually use for my Harley Quinn makeup right here. And then I have this red one, which is the normal blush that I use. I'm going to take that. And in the 50s, they would have used a thing called cream rouge, which I don't think I have the hand to use because it requires a pretty gentle hand, and it's like red and it makes your cheeks rosier. Because, you know, the 50s was kind of known to be feminine, given the dress, you know, the dress shapes and the women's role in the household. And it was kind of just a return to traditionalism because of the chaos of World War II that affected everyone greatly. Right, eyes. So I'm actually going to try and get a little closer so you can see. That didn't help. So, what I'm going to be using is one of my favorite, this is like my favorite eyeshadow palette because it goes with everything. I mean, every girl uses this eyeshadow and it's browns. And I've got my makeup brush with my Harry Potter wand. This is Voldemort's wand, which is probably the one I use the most. Or this one or the one with Hermione's wand. Oh my gosh. I would kill to do a Harry Potter video. So this is going on my lid. And I picked this, like, light brown. Actually, I have a mirror. I picked the light brown because the brown really goes with the cream on the dress. I wanted to use a light color without actually, got makeup on the table. I wanted to use a lighter color just to, I wanted to use a lighter color, like a lighter brown, not a cream, because the dress skirt is cream. And the 50s, your eyeshadow matched your dress. So, like, if you had a purple dress, you'd wear some purple eyeshadow. Or if you had, like, a white dress with, like, pink pearls, you'd wear, like, a pinky kind of eyeshadow. I'm not the biggest fan of pink. I will wear it, like, don't get me wrong. Like, there are some shades of pink I really like. Like, that pale blush pink is so pretty. An ombre. I really like a pink and blue ombre. Like the pink, like the cotton candy ombre. That's something I really like. I think it's pretty. BTS's album Love Yourself has that ombre effect, which is why that's what drew me to that album, is because of how pretty it was. The next palette I'm going to be using is for the red to make the cardinal stand out. I'm going to be using this ruby red right here. This, like, ruby red. And I'm not going to use it on my entire eyelid because red is a bit of a statement. I did this a lot my freshman year. I'd wear brown eyeshadow and then I'd outline it with red because I wore a red scrunchie every day. So that's kind of what I'm going to do here. I'm kind of going to, put it on the outside, like, and blend it kind of with the, I want to make it kind of like a wing, so I'm not actually putting it on the brow bone or crease all the way, but, like, a shadow. Also, today was my last day of school for the rest of this year. Until we go back in January. I'm really excited to go back. I have missed going to school. A lot of people can disagree, but I love going to school. It's where all my friends are. It's great. I like going, you know. I'm taking that eyeshadow and I'm kind of putting it, dusting it over the brown to make it look a little rose gold. Then, brown so you can see it. I don't know if you can see it. If you can see it, great. I'm sorry, my camera is so bad. My camera work is awful. This Harry Potter makeup brush is Harry's wand. And this was the makeup brush I used the most last year, was Harry's. To top off the eyeshadow, I have this loose glitter eyeshadow that I used a lot too, because I thought it was really nice. And it's gold, which I think will bring out the music notes really well because they're like a goldy color. However, loose eyeshadows, especially glitter ones, are not my friends. They have a tendency to get all over me. So I'm putting that glitter over the, where the brown is, where I put that, like, light brown and the red on my lid. I'm kind of just dusting over it because I don't want too much glitter because it's a little bit of a statement. There's the glitter. I don't know if you can see it. Just also an FYI, this is going to be the makeup I'm wearing on Christmas Day, not Christmas Eve. Technically, I will be wearing this dress with the petticoat on Christmas Day, and I'll have this makeup done. I don't know what I'm wearing Christmas Eve. I think I'm going to wear my flannel skirt. Maybe. Mm-hmm. We'll see. My phone just went off. to finish off the eyes, I'm using some mascara. And 50s mascara actually wasn't a wand and tube. It had been invented in, like, the 20s. It had been invented in the 20s. But, it wasn't super popular until the, 60s and 70s. And what women would use to do their mascara was they would use this thing they called, cake mascara. And it was a paste. It was like a mascara paste that you would, wet, and then you'd put a brush into it, and then you'd do it like this. Which, if you want to see what these things look like, obviously you can Google them. But there's a store in, Burbank, California called, well, there's stores everywhere of this brand. It's called Besame Cosmetics. this is not sponsored. They sell, vintage makeup. And they have the rouge, they have the cream and cake mascara. They have lipsticks. They have a lot of lipsticks. They have makeup setting sprays and all that jazz. They have a lot. And I really like that. And now to finish off the look, the crowning glory, the lipstick. This, I actually went with a wine red instead of like a victory red. Victory red lipstick is like your bright red lipstick, like your Heather Chandler or Cheryl Blossom Riverdale people is that color lipstick, the really bright red. I went with a more wine red because I feel like, because the wine red really would make this red pop more and not my lips as much. Because the part, I'm having, I guess, a party, not really, at my house. But on the off chance we go out, I have the mask that I will wear instead of lipstick. It looks like an ugly Christmas sweater. But you can still see my eyes. I mean, it's not gonna kill me. Put that back. Put that back. But I don't think we're leaving my house Christmas Day, so I get to wear lipstick. It's been a while since I wore lipstick, because I haven't had the need to, because Rona. Last time I wore lipstick, I think, was last year. Okay. Let's put the lipstick on. The, last time I wore this, this red was when I went to a 1920s themed dance. They still have the flapper dress that I wore. We have the pearls that I wore. I remember the makeup I did because I wanted it all to match. So I used dark red. That was the last time I wore this dark lipstick. And I think it really gives a vintage feel. I really like darker colored lipsticks. I do like brighter lipsticks too, like pinks and reds, because they go with everything. Oh, I gotta let my hair down, of course. My hair is going to be down. I don't know what I'm doing for my hair. I want to do 50s hair, but I have no idea what. I wanted to try my hand at victory rolls, but I'm like, Let's save that for the 4th of July. Now that's my Christmas makeup. So that is the end of yesterday's video, which is what I would have been doing yesterday. So, I guess let's do today's video. So I really didn't know what I was doing, what I wanted to do. And then I thought I would talk about, like, some of, like, I wanted to talk about dress history, because that's something I'm really into, but I couldn't think of any, like, anything like that to talk about. So we're going to talk about the one thing that always happens to me around Christmas time, and that probably happens to a lot of you guys on Christmas time, is congestions. Stuffed noses really bother me, because I'm always sniffling, and I'm always having to go blow my nose every 5 minutes. It's really annoying. Some treatments my mom has for it is Vicks, or if you guys know what Vicks is, or Vaseline. I guess not Vaseline, but it has like a really strong, like minty almost scent to it, and you rub it on your neck, and you put like a sock over it, and when you breathe that in, it clears up your nasal passage, and bye bye stuffed nose. I really wanted to do, I had like many different videos planned for today. First, I was going to do covers, and then I'm like, well, no, then I have to do two videos. So, I think I will do a cover. I have no idea what song. If you are in a different location when I start recording, then I am doing, a cover. So...
A man undercover. tore me apart. Ooh, ooh, well, I found a real love, you'll never fool me again. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Last Christmas, I gave you my heart. You gave it away. To save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Face of a lover with a fire in his heart. A man undercover, but you tore me apart.
So that is going to wrap it up for today's video. I hope you enjoyed my cover. I messed it up a couple times, but that's okay. I hope you enjoyed the makeup tutorial. I think it's something new, something different. I mean, something that I did a while ago. Thank you so much for watching. I purple you. Have a Merry Christmas. Oh, wait, you'll see me tomorrow. But whatever holiday you celebrate, have a good one, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!